Hi everyone, welcome to Lecture 60 in EDC course. In this lecture, we will discuss about the characteristics of common base configuration. So the objective of this lecture is to discuss the input characteristics of CB configuration or common base configuration. So first I will draw the common base configuration. Next we'll see what are the input parameters and output parameters. And here I am using NPN transistor. We can use PNP transistor also. So this is NPN transistor. So this is emitter terminal, collector terminal and base terminal. So I'm denoting this is emitter, collector and base terminals, right? So NPN. And remember, in common base configuration, base is common to input and output terminals. So I'm taking this base to reference terminal or ground terminal, and I will apply input at emitter side. So for that, so we need to apply the biasing voltages, and remember in which region there will be a transistor action. Active region. In active region, emitter base junction should be forward bias. So emitter is N, so N side should be connected to negative side of the battery, and P type or P side should be connected to positive side of the battery. So what is this polarities and our voltage? Plus minus VBE. If I am using this in some circuits, we may find some resistance also here, right? R1, R2 and so on. So for explanation purpose, we can neglect those resistances. In collector side also, so collector side generally output side, I told you, no? So this is input and collector side output. So and remember, in active region, collector base junction should be reverse bias. So N side should be connected to positive side of the battery, P side should be connected to negative side of the battery. So what is this polarities and voltage? So plus minus, so collector side is positive, so VCB, right? And what are the currents, terminal currents? So the emitter current will leave the emitter, that means collector current should enter into the collector side, base side also should be entering, right? So these are the currents and their directions. So IE, IB and IC are positive when we give the directions like this. Similarly, in this case, VBE and VCB are positive. So when I take PNP transistor, all these currents and voltages will be negative. Otherwise, we can change like VEB, VBC, etc. Right? So that you can try on your own when it is a PNP transistor, what are the voltages and what are the current directions. So, but in this case, all are positive only. So, why the emitter current is out of the emitter? Very simple. When the emitter base junction is forward bias, emitter will emit the electrons and the collector will collect those electrons due to collector base junction reverse bias. So, electrons are moving from emitter to the collector. So, what is the current direction? Opposite of electron movement. So, electrons are moving like this. So, current will move opposite of the electron movement. So that's why emitter current is out of the emitter terminal. So collector is collecting the electrons like this. So electron movement is like this. Opposite of electron movement is the current direction. So in the base, when the electrons are coming into the base, some electrons recombine with the holes. So that means holes are missing in the base. So those holes must be provided by this base terminal. So base is providing holes like this. So what is the current direction? Same in the direction of hole movement. So that's why the base current is into the base terminal and the collector current is into the collector. So I hope it is clear. Next we'll see what are the input characteristics. That is how the input current is changing with respect to the input voltage. And later in the next lecture we'll see output characteristics. So but where is the output? At the collector side. So this is the output side. Right. So first we'll define what are the input parameters and output parameters, then we'll see input characteristics. So this is the input side. So what are the input current and input voltage? See here. So emitter is now acting like an input. So emitter current is input current, and emitter to base voltage, that is VBE, will act as input voltage. So input parameters IE and VBE, right? So for different configurations we'll get different input parameters. For common base, IE and VBE are the input parameters. Next, what are the output parameters? Output parameter, simple. What is the output current and output voltage? So what are those? So this IC is the output current and this VCB is the output voltage. Next we will see how this emitter current is changing with respect to the VBE and VCB. So remember, when we discussed the early effect, this emitter current will dependent on the, or we can say, function of VBE and VCB. So first I will explain the early effect in a quick way, then we'll draw the input characteristics, that is IE versus VBE, for different values of VCB, right? So first we'll see what is early effect. So what is early effect? So when we increase the reverse bias voltage, so there is a change in the IE and IC. So that we'll see. So common base, so this is the base, emitter, base, collector. So this is forward bias and this is reverse bias, and initially there will be a depletion region, right? So collector side is small because the base is very lightly doped. So this is the total base width and this is the effective base width where the carriers are existing. So in a NPN, here holes will exist. Now as the reverse bias, what is this voltage? Plus minus VCB, or VBC is negative. As VCB is increasing, what happens to the depletion layer width? That is decreases. So depletion layer width is W, is increases. So this is this line to this line is actually W. So VCB is increasing, depletion layer width is increasing. So as the depletion layer width is increasing, the effective base width will decreases. As the effective base width is decreasing, what happens? The carriers in the base are reducing. That means a recombination in the base decreases. Recombination in the base decreases. That means we can say recombination in base decreases. That means the current IB decreases. So what happens to the two currents? IE and IC will increase. IE increases, IC increases. Or we can say combinedly the current gain alpha increases. Right? So this is the early effect. So what is actually happening? This emitter current is increasing as we increase the VCB. So that is early effect. Now we'll see the input characteristics, that is IE versus VBE, for different values of VCB. So actually this is for IE versus VBE, right? But this IE is depending on VCB also, so that's why we'll get multiple curves, that is for different VCB values. But before that we'll see in common base. So what is this base emitter junction or emitter to base junction? It's a PN junction. So first I will take that one. So it is a PN junction, and here also a PN junction, and this is the base, this is the emitter, this is for explanation purpose, remember, and this is the collector. Now here this emitter base junction is forward bias. That means it, the behavior in this emitter base junction will be looking like a diode only, that is forward diode. So if you recall, what is the diode current equation? ID is equal to the reverse saturation current IS into e power diode voltage VD by eta VT, or approximately we can take VT minus 1. If I go approximately, I can neglect this one. So IS into e power VD by VT. So that means the diode current is exponentially related to diode voltage. The same relation we will apply here also in common base. So in common base, what is the diode voltage? That is VBE. And what is the diode current? IE. So how these are related? So IE is equal to ISE, that is emitter base junction cross sectional area. So here in IS we'll have emitter base junction cross sectional area, that's why we have to replace ISE into e power VBE by VT, right? So R, I can take approximately alpha is equal to 1, then it will become IS into e power VBE by VT. Otherwise, if I go to exactly, if you recall, alpha into ISC is actually scale current IS. So what is IS here? Alpha times ISC. But what is ISC? IS by alpha. So that means if I go to exactly, it is IS by alpha. And if I take approximately alpha 1, then it is IS into e power VBE by VT. This is I. So that is emitter current and emitter to base voltage are exponentially related. Now, how to draw the characteristics? Very simple. So for diode, we have seen the exponential characteristics. That is something like this, right? This is ID versus VD. So that we have to see here also. So carefully observe. So initially up to cut-in voltage, there is no current, right? Then slightly the current increases and it will be like a exponential relation. And we have to denote some voltages, that is where the current is start flowing. So generally we can say that is cut-in voltage. So V gamma, that is cut-in voltage. So generally it is for silicon 0.6 volts, right? Silicon, and 0.2 volts for germanium, right? But actually where we will get the sufficient current, so that is at the forward bias voltage. So 0.7 volt for silicon, 0.3 volt for germanium. So here we will get the current, so the sufficient current, or we can say at 0.7 volt we will get the maximum current also. So as the voltage VBE is increasing, so we will get the increment in the emitter current or diode current, right? If I assume this is VCB for 1 volt, or we can assume for 0 volts also, VCB can be 0. Now what happens when we increase the VCB? That we have seen already. If I increase the VCB, IE increases. So that means for less values of VBE, we will get the same current as we are getting for VCB is equal to 1. Or we can say if VB is fixed, if VCB is increasing, the current IE also increases. So that means that these characteristics will shift towards the origin side, right? So we'll get something like this. The same characteristics, only slight shift in this towards the origin side. Why? Because as the VCB is increasing, IE is increasing, right? So this curve is for VCB, suppose 5 volts, right? So I'm increasing VCB. Now, if I still increase like a 10 volts, then again it will shift something like this. And see, this 0.7 will be almost fixed for all the curves. So this is for VCB 10 volts, right? Now if I increase like a 20 volts, so it may shift up to here, so on and so on, right? So as the VCB is increasing, so this curve will shift towards left side, right? So this is the input characteristics, that is IE versus VBE. And I forgot to give the units. So IE will be in the milliamperes range and VBE in volts. So always remember, whenever you are plotting the graph, so always try to give the units for the currents and voltages, right? Sometimes these currents will be in microamperes or nanoamperes, so we need to provide the units, right? So what are these characteristics? input characteristics, input characteristics of common base configuration. So why we are calling it as input characteristics? So the plot is between the input current IE and input voltage VBE. Now here we need to find one important thing that is called input resistance. So this is very important parameter when we draw the small signal model. So input resistance, right? So denotation we will represent by small re in common base. Why? Because we are applying the input to the emitter. So when I draw one more time this common base configuration, so collector, base, emitter, so minus plus plus minus VBE, and this is IE. So this is the input side, this is connected. So when I look into this emitter, so we'll find input resistance, right? So how this emitter current is changing? By applying small changes in the VBE. So that will give the input resistance. So output side we can draw like this also, but not required. Plus minus VCB, and this is IC. So how to find the input resistance? Small RE. Very simple. When I see the characteristics, that is IE versus VBE, these are not linear. As I know, they are exponential. So but we should take one point where we need to operate the PN junction diode. So suppose this is some IE and this is some VBE1, this is IE1. Then when I apply very small change in the VBE1, then we'll get maybe some linear curve, right? So when I get a linear curve, then we'll get the resistance value, right? So how to find that resistance? So this slope will give the actually 1 by RE, I by V, right? But how to find RE, we'll see that. I will find using the diode current equation, that is IE is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT, right? So if I differentiate this expression with respect to the VBE, what I will get? So DIE by DVBE, this is constant, e power x only into, I have to differentiate this, so that is x. So with respect to VBE means 1 by VT. So what is this? I by V will get the conductance, or 1 by resistance, 1 by RE is equal to, what is this actually? IE only, right? So IE by VT. So what is VT? We know thermal voltage. So finally the input resistance RE is equal to VT by IE only. So this is the input resistance in common base configuration. It is depending on the input current, which is emitter current. And what is the VT? Thermal voltage. Thermal voltage. What is the value? It is KT by Q. So 25 millivolts at room temperature, some books follows, or 26 millivolts at room temperature. Now when we have to use this input resistance? So very simple. Suppose once I fixed this VBE like a 0.7 volts, right? If I apply a small signal, so there is a small signal we are applying to get amplification of this signal, then due to the variation in the small voltage, how this emitter current is changing, that will be given by a parameter. That parameter is this resistance RE. Why? That we know, right? So R is equal to V by I. As this RE is changing, that means I is changing. So how this I is changing will be decided by this resistance RE, and this resistance parameter will be used to get required gains. So this RE will be used to find gains in this CB configurations, common base configurations. So if I fix this RE, we may get one type of gain, that is 10 gain, 20 gain. If I use RE in a different way, we may get large gains, we may get smaller gains, and so on. So this RE is very, very important point, and this formula also very, very important. How we are getting RE as VT by IE. So this is the explanation. You can follow that. And the final conclusion is, so whenever the common base configuration is there, we need to use the, what are the input parameters? Parameters IE and VBE. So these are the DC values or DC parameters. Remember, DC parameters. So when I use the small signals, we have to use the small letters, sorry, small VB. That is, once I fix this DC value, so when we apply these small signals, how the transistor behaves. So this is like a AC parameter, AC parameters. Then we will get the this small resistance RE, which is called input resistance in common base configuration. Next, we should know current relationship, that is IC is equal to alpha times IE, right? And when I go for the small signal model, so we have to use small IC and small IE. So this is alpha only, right? So later we'll see in common emitter, generally beta will be denoted by HFE, right? But alpha, so it is always approximately 1, so there is no different name for alpha, right? So this is alpha times IE. And when I take this common base configuration, something like this, and this is like this, plus minus VCB, plus minus VBE. So when I want to draw the model for this, so base terminal is common and I am getting the emitter current, right? So emitter will be replaced by simply RE, because when we apply the small signal models or small signals, the emitter base junction will behave as simply the resistance RE. So this is the our input resistance. How to find? Simply thermal voltage by the DC emitter current. And this is the collector. And we know the collector current is dependent on the emitter current. This is small IE or capital IE also. That means the collector current is depending on the emitter current. How? Alpha times IE. So that's why it is dependent current source, right? Because the collector current is depending on the emitter current. How? Alpha times IE. So what is this model? Generally it is called T model. So actually we should discuss this in analog circuits. But I am telling here only because we are dealing with the common base. In common base, what are the parameters we can find? So that is small RE. Always remember, whenever you take any transistor, when you are looking into the emitter, I can see a resistance RE. When you are looking into the base, I will see some resistance that is called R pi. Later we will see in common emitter configuration R pi. So when I am looking at the emitter, so always it will become thermal voltage by IE. When I am looking into the base, simple VT by base current IB, right? So that is how to find these small signal resistances in common base, common emitter, etc. In common collector, we'll apply the again the input current to the base only. Again, that means we'll get R pi only. So we'll not look into the collector. So I hope it is clear. Now mainly we should know these characteristics, how these characteristics are shifting into the origin side as we are increasing the reverse bias voltage VCB. So I hope it is clear. In the next lecture, we'll see output characteristics of common base configuration.